أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله، وبعد. In Surah Al-Hujurat, Surah number 49, verse 11, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٌ مِّنْ قَوْمٍ عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّنْ نِسَاءٍ عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان ومن لم يتب فأولئك هم الظالمون. So the verse starts, O believers, let not a people ridicule another people, mock another people, for perhaps they are better than them. So the mocked perhaps are better than the ones who ridicule them. And let not women ridicule other women, perhaps they are better than them. It was narrated that this part or this verse, and especially this statement in the verse, was revealed when Sayyidina Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl radiyallahu anhu wa ardah became a Muslim, and he was son of Abu Jahl, the one who had great enmity against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and against Islam and against all Muslims. But Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl accepted Islam. He became a Muslim, and then he migrated to Al-Madinah. So some of the companions, because of the great enmity that Abu Jahl used to have against Islam and Muslims and the Prophet, so they couldn't imagine that Ikrimah could be a good Muslim. And they started saying, Ikrimah ibn Fir'aun hadhihi al-ummah. Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called Abu Jahl Fir'aun hadhihi al-ummah, the Pharaoh of this nation. Because the Pharaoh was, you know, a very wicked and aggressive personality in history. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told about Abu Jahl, he's like the Pharaoh. He's the Pharaoh in the ummah of Islam. So some of the companions used to say, whenever they would see Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl, they want to say, oh, this is son of the Pharaoh of this nation. So Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl got upset because of this. And he went to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he told him about it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٌ مِّنْ قَوْمٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُونُوا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّنْ نِسَاءٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ. O believers, again, let not a people ridicule other people, for perhaps the mocked are better than, you know, those who mock them. So subhanallah, look at the justice of Islam. So this was the son of the greatest enemy to Islam and to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to all Muslims. But now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told all of the companions, don't upset him, don't keep reminding him all the time that it is a fact. Yes, he is son of the Pharaoh of this nation. This is a fact. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed a Quranic verse, you know, which is will be, you know, recited till the day of judgment, giving a very clear command to all the Muslims, not to call Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl, you know, like, you know, he's son of the Pharaoh of this nation. Because in Islam, أَلَّا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. No soul will carry the burden of another. So everyone is responsible for his own acts. So it was not his fault that he was son of Abu Jahl. And again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the companions, it could be that
he may be better than you. Son of Abu Jahl may be better than you. So don't mock him. And actually, mocking others is a very, grave sin, because the one who mocks others, he is actually belittling them. And this is a sign of arrogance. And whosoever in whose heart is an atom weight of arrogance, he will never enter paradise, as the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ told. And the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ told, Al-kibru ghamtu al-haqqi, al-kibru batru al-haqqi wa ghamtu al-nas. Al-kibr, arrogance, is to reject the truth, is to refuse to accept the truth, And it is ghamt al-nas, it is belittling people. Ghams al-nas, belittling people, and in another narration, ghamt al-nas, despising people. So that is something that all Muslims should avoid. Then the verses continue. وَلَا نِسَاءٌ مِّن نِسَاءٍ عَسَىٰ أَن يَكُنَّ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُنْ وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. And do not defame yourselves. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the meaning is, do not defame each other, or do not defame one another. Do not insult one another. But the verse doesn't literally say, do not defame one another, but it says, وَلَا تَلْمِزُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Do not defame yourselves. Because as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told, Muslims are like one body. So they are like, one thing. So if someone defames another, it is as if he is defaming himself. Because they are, all Muslims are like one body and one entity. And there was a narration, a sahih hadith, that one of the companions, whose name was Al-Ma'rur, he said, I ra'aytu Aba Dharrin bin Rabada. I have met with the companion, the famous companion Sayyidina Abu Dharr bin Rabada, in a place called Al-Rabada. And he was wearing wa'alayhi hulla wa'ala khadimihi hulla. And he was wearing a cloak, and his slave was wearing a similar cloak, a type of garment. فسألته عن ذلك. So I inquired about this, because it seemed strange for Sayyidina Al-Ma'rur that Abu Dharr was wearing a cloak and his slave and servant was wearing a similar cloak of the same quality. So Abu Dharr answered him saying, سببت رجلا. I insulted a man, and actually he meant by rajulan here his slave, the same person. فَعَيَّرْتُهُ بِأُمِّهِ. And I insulted him by reviling his mother. And he actually told him, يَبْنَ السَّوْدَاءِ. O son of the black woman. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, إِنَّكَ امْرُؤٌ فِيكَ جَاهِلِيَّةٌ. You are a person who still has some characters of the ignorance period, the pre-Islamic period of ignorance. Then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam continued, إِخْوَانُكُمْ خَوَالُكُمْ فَأَطْعِمُوهُمْ مِمَّا تَأْكُلُونَ وَأَلْبِسُوهُمْ مِمَّا تَلْبَسُونَ وَلَا تُكَلِّفُوهُمْ مَا لَا يَطِيقُونَ فَإِنْ كَلَّفْتُمُوهُمْ فَأَعِينُوهُمْ. Then the Prophet added, after advising Sayyidina Abu Dharr not to do this again and telling him that this is a bad sign, of the characters of the pre-Islamic period of Jahiliyyah, then the Prophet continued telling him, your slaves are your brothers. So when you eat, give them from the same food that you eat from, and dress them from the same clothes that you wear, and do not command them to do things beyond their capacities. And if you do so, then help them. So that's why Sayyidina Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu wa arda, he responded to the advice of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and since then he started feeding his slave from his foot and dressing his slave you know, from his clothes as well. So getting for him the same clothes as he used to get for himself. وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ. So of course you see in Islam, you know, it's not even prohibited to you know, insult friends or neighbors or relatives, but even slaves. And with the least word, he only mentioned one word, you know, by telling him, you are son of the black woman. But of course, this is strictly forbidden. And it is strictly forbidden to be said, whether to equals or to weak people like servants, or at that time to be said to slaves. And this shows, you know, the beauty of Islam, of course, and the justice of Islam and the rahmah of Islam, and that in Islam all people are equal, and no one can take advantage of his power or wealth or, you know, or position in this world, you know, to give bad treatment to anybody else or to insult anybody else. Then the verse says, وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ. And do not call each other by offensive nicknames. Like what? Like, for example, if someone is blind, so it is prohibited to call him the blind. For example, if he's coming, it is prohibited to say to your brother, to your friend, oh, the blind is coming, or to address him, oh, blind man, come here. Or if someone is very thin, for example, it is also prohibited to give him a nickname, an offensive nickname that, of course, he does not like. Or if he is known for being very slow, for example, you know, he walks very, you know, slowly, for example, or he does things, he takes time, you know, to finish, you know, achieving different things. So don't call him, oh, slow man, you come now. So these are the nicknames that people don't like to be called with. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanallah, Allah, the creator of the heavens and the earth and the whole universe, is because he is the most merciful and the most compassionate, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like for any human being to be upset or to be ill-treated in this world. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Noble Quran tells us and gives us guidance regarding all of this. And the Noble Quran is a comprehensive book of guidance. It tells us everything that you know takes our hands to the real happiness, and also which keeps our relationship proper and and a good one. And then the verse ends, وَمَنْ لَنْ يَتُبْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ Then the verse says, بِئْسَ الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ. And this very important phrase, بِئْسَ الْإِسْمُ الْفُسُوقُ بَعْدَ الْإِيمَانِ. الْفُسُوقُ, you know, فُسُوقُ is from فَاسِق. When someone is فَاسِق, the فَاسِق is the one who exceeds the limits, is the one who's disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the one who doesn't care about following the teachings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah is telling the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, only because they told Sayyidina Akbar ibn Abi Jahl, Ibn Fir'aun hadhihi al-umma, son of the Pharaoh of this nation, Allah warned them and told them, you know, beware of this, beware of going back to fusuq, you know, to disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ba'da al-iman. Bi'sa al-ismu al-fusuqu ba'da al-iman means wretched is disobedience after one's faith. So you have already become Muslims, and you have already become good believers, and you have already started having true faith and perfect faith in Allah. So it's very bad that after achieving this, you go back to fusuq, which means that these sins are very serious ones. And some of these scholars, they said, they are among the kaba'ir as well. Because they said one of the signs of kaba'ir is that if it is named like it leads to fusuq, then it is kabira. So to mock someone or to call him by an offensive nickname, or to slander or abuse him or any one of his you know, relatives or family members or whatever, then it could be one of the kabair, which is major sins. So of course, all Muslims should avoid. And that's why then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the same verse, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَتُبْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. And whosoever does not repent to Allah, then those are the wrongdoers. So it means that because these are common mistakes that many people, even Muslims, even good Muslims, unintentionally, by mistake, or out of forgetfulness, they may, you know, do one of these mistakes. And that's why we need tawbah. So, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَتُبْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. You have to make tawbah because, you know, it must be that one day you have, you know, committed one of these mistakes. So you need to make tawbah. Otherwise, if you don't make tawbah, then you are amongst the wrongdoers. And you know, in subhanallah, the akhlaq are connected to the worship. And in siyam, for example, the Prophet ﷺ said, مَنْ لَمْ يَدْعَ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةٍ فِي أَنْ يَدْعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. Whosoever does not abandon false speech and acting accordingly, then his leaving of his food and drink is useless in the sight of Allah. His fasting is not accepted. So fasting is to take us to a higher degree, because a Muslim should be avoiding sins during the whole year. But fasting take us to a higher degree, which is, in addition to avoiding sins, then we give up food and drink from dawn to sunset, so we are spiritually more prepared to draw closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to focus on the, like mentioning Allah, remembering Allah, reading Quran, or you know, to strengthen the spiritual side in ourselves. So you know, these things are very important. They are of the same importance, you know, like all other fara'id, like the salah and the all other fara'id. So inshallah, inshallah, we have to be inshallah careful about you know, things like this, inshallah, so that when we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we worship Him by doing the salah and the siyam and the zakah, and you know, these pure sorts of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also practically in our life and the way we treat each other and the way we treat all people, also we have to follow the way shown to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us all and accept all of our good deeds. And inshallah, I was told yesterday that cousin of our dear brother Siraj has passed away a couple of days ago in Libya. And our brother Dr. Siraj, he now is in Libya. So inshallah, we make dua for him, inshallah. Cousin of our brother Dr. Siraj has passed away a couple of days ago. So make dua for him, inshallah, now that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants him his forgiveness, inshallah, and admits him to Al-Firdaus Al-A'la, and grants him company of our noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all the righteous. Barakallahu fi. Allahumma laka alhamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhika wa azim sultanik. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin fil awwalin, wa salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin fil akhirin, wa salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin fil mala'i al-a'la ila yawmiddin. اللهم اغفر له وارحمه، اللهم تجاوز عن سيئاته واعف عنه، اللهم اكرم نزله، اللهم وسع مدخله، اللهم ابدله نورا خيرا من داره واهلا خيرا من اهله، اللهم اغسله من خطاياه بالماء والثلج والبرد، اللهم نقه من خطاياه كما نقيت الثوب الابيض من الدنس، اللهم زد في حسناته، اللهم تجاوز عن سيئاته، اللهم اجعل قبره روضة من رياض الجنة، اللهم ولا تجعله حفرة من حفر النار، اللهم قيه فتنة القبر، اللهم قيه عذاب القبر، اللهم لقنه حجته يا رب العالمين، اللهم ارزقه صحبة النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين، وحسن أولئك رفيقا، اللهم بشره بمقعده في الجنة يا رب العالمين، اللهم ارزقه شفاعة نبيك صلى الله عليه وسلم، اللهم باعد بينه وبين خطاياه كما باعدت بين المشرق والمغرب، اللهم اغسله من خطاياه بالماء والثلج والبرد، اللهم نقيه من خطاياه كما نقيت الثوب الابيض من الدنس، اللهم اجعله من الذين لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون، اللهم اجعله من اهل السعاده الكامله الدائمه التي لا شقاء معها ابدا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر له ولأمواتنا وأموات المسلمين أجمعين، وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
إن الله وملائكة مَكَّةَ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا.